efficacy of the Botox. Right? It does not flop, it does not slip into the soup. It does not flop into your flask. I do not need a timer after I put my time on. And I've told the story a few times. In fact, I told it to Ken Ham. You guys don't remember this. So my grandfather told me this. Now, you know, you're a kid, they present this to you as a true story. I don't know if it's really a true story, but it's on the beginning of the debate if you want to watch it. But he was in the Rotary, which is, you know, a community service, something or other organization. And they had a convention in Philadelphia. And he rented a, this is the story, okay? He said to have rented a tuxedo. And even in those days, it came with a tie, and he didn't know how to tie the bow tie. So he just went to the hotel room next door. And I grew up in Washington, D.C., take the train photo. And so he just went, you know, excuse me, can you help me tie my tie? And the guy said, yeah, lie down on the bed. And so the story of my grandfather is said to have lain on the bed, and the guy is said to have tied a perfect bow tie knot. And you know, my grandfather said, thank you, why'd I have to lie down? Guess what, I'm an undertaker. Same knot as on your shoe. Okay, it's the same knot. Now, I just want to say to you, half of you in here probably tie your shoes so they come untied all the time. Anybody? Yeah, so, oh, look at the victims. So, what you want, I will try to do this here, what you want is a square knot. So, study. So you want a square knot. You will recognize it if you work on a ship. It's the same knot. It's called a reef knot for reefing the sails, making the sails shorter in the storm. You want it to be square. You want it to be symmetrical. So to those of you who tie your shoes, the wrong, who ties his or her shoes so they come untied all the time? Who's here? Anybody? Who can we get a moment? Yes, with the cell phone. Come on up. Do you have tie shoes? Do you have laces shoes on right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. That's key. That's key. No, but the shoes weren't to slip on Toms or something. Although they're lace up Toms. Here she comes. What's your name, you know?
My name's Ariel.
Yeah, and so these come untied all the time?
Yes.
They don't really? The left one does,
yes,
right? Yeah, so please untie it. Yeah, now try to reverse the first knot. So go to start to tie it. And you go, I'm watching you, you go right over left, right? And see if you can stop yourself. You know, back up. Untie it. And instead of swinging the right one over the left one, see if you can swing the left one over the right one. Yes. Now wrap the left one underneath. Yes. Now finish the way you always do. Snug it down. Oh, that's going to be backwards. Try it to, oh yeah, let go. Yes. So see, if you can do that, what you want is when you tie up, oh, thank you, Ariel. Is that right? Did I get it right? Thank you. You want it to go straight across like this. Okay? You don't, if you end up with a going like this, then it will, first of all, look odd. Secondly, then your shoes, see how mine, I don't know if you can see in this light, mine lace goes like this, just like on your neck. And I'll just tell you guys, you can learn to do it. And then, as a social commentary, arbitrary guy from my culture, I grew up on a certain age, my dad always walked on the street side to protect my mother from flying glass or whatever. My mom could tell you, by the way, ladies, my mom got a doctorate, okay, after she was in the Navy. She got a master's degree and a doctorate, and she wrote her name, Ms. MS, period, and she hyphenated her last name, my mom. Along with that, she could tell you that if it says black tie, the gentlemen wear black ties with their tuxedos and the ladies wear dresses that extend below the knee. If it says white tie, the gentlemen wear white ties and the ladies must wear gowns that reach the floor and gloves. This is stuff that was important to my mother while she had a doctorate and hyphenated her name and marched in the ER at an Equal Rights Amendment parade and told us that she threw her bra in the fire. She liked playing both sides a little bit, and, you know, the chivalry and so on. So when you want to be dressed up, guys, and you wear a tuxedo, wear a bow